In this week's episode of Fishing, Boating, Exploring, we head off for a family boating adventure, explore one of Fraser Island's gorgeous little creeks, there is some paddleboard fun, we talk about how much fuel you need for your next boating trip, and enjoy lunch inside Wathumba Creek, a must-visit boating destination on the Fraser Coast. G'day, my name is Luke, and this is my wife, Jen. And here are our two growing boys, Liam and Elliot. We've been fishing, boating, and exploring the pristine waters of the Fraser Coast for about 10 years now. So subscribe and come join the adventure. Okay, make sure you got your jackets on, everybody. It's gonna be a little chilly.
Oh, here we go.
Our journey today sees us heading northeast across the deep water channels towards Moon Point on Fraser Island. We then hug Fraser Island as we boat further north towards Wathumba Creek.
So I reckon we pull up, have a bit of explore of this little area up here. Looks like there's a sign up there. Have a bit of a flip for some flathead at the front of this little creek, Liam. Yeah, that's 3 meters deep. You can see the bottom. And the sun's not even out yet. Rightio, folks, so we've pulled up on Fraser Island. I don't exactly know where we are. I know that over there is the Triangle Cliffs. Jen's got the paddleboard out. We're getting just bored driving up the island and we just wanted to pull up. And there's a dingo running around up on the beach.
Looks like on the camera, but she's a good 40, 50 meters away from him. Having a paddle and looking at a dingo on the beach of Fraser Island. It's pretty special.
What do you want to do, Elliot?
Go to the creek.
We're here to explore. You got bitten by a crab. Is that the crab rave that you're doing? Okay, so have you had a look at the creek? Do you want to show me what you found? Oh wow, look at those colours. That water looks amazing out there. Excited, aren't you?
What do you think? Not with Fraser.
Do you like this grass? This grass is cool. Look at all the knobbly bits on it. How pretty are those flowers?
Wow.
Yeah. Pig's face, I think it's called. Oh wow, it still says till the 31st of May, which is, I think, today actually. I'm pretty sure there's no stingers now. It's a bit cold. Here's where we are. Bowal Creek. I'm not sure how to say that.
Creek. Bowal Creek.
Camping area.
One of the questions I get quite a lot through social media, whether it be the Facebook page, Instagram, even through YouTube, a lot of people contact me and ask about, the most recent question, how much fuel will I need to get to Wathumba Creek and back? I've got a 90 or 75 horsepower Mercury, okay? That question's pretty much almost impossible to answer without a couple of key pieces of information. So I just wanted to talk about that today. In the last 6 months, this boat has towed 5 boats back to the Urangan harbour, and all of those boats have been between the northern tip of Big Woody Island and the harbour, and they've just fallen short, and they've all been fuel issues. 3 of them were run out of fuel, and the other 2 were, we think, fuel filters and things like that. So fancy boats will have a computer on it that will tell you how much fuel you're consuming, how much distance you've gone, what your range is, all that sort of stuff. Fancy sounders like the Hummingbird Solix will tell me all that as well, okay? And I know the other brands will do that. And you've also got the fuel sender unit in your fuel tank that'll tell you whether you've got full fuel, three quarters, half tank, all that. But what do you do if you don't have any of that? And what do you do if none of that is working? You need to be able to calculate how far you can go and how much fuel you'll need. First thing is, you need to understand the rule of thirds, all right? Before I go any further, the rule of thirds. A third of your fuel to get to where you want to go, a third of your fuel to get back, and a third spare. That is the golden rule, okay? Too many times I see people who work out their calculations and they say, I'll need 100 litres of fuel to get up to there and back, and I should have five spare. And they're the ones that run out of fuel on the way back, because there are variables that are going to influence your average fuel consumption. Wind, tide, other conditions, okay? So that's the first thing you need to understand, rule of thirds. A third to get there, a third to get back, and a third spare, okay? Just live by that rule. One of the things you need to know is, what is the fuel capacity of your tank on your boat? All right, so I've got 150 litres in my tank on this boat. You might have 60. My old boat used to have a 60 litre underfloor tank. All right, so you need to know what the fuel capacity is of the tank on your boat. Now, the other thing you need to do is you need to work out an average of fuel consumption. The easiest way to do that, and this is what I did in my Quintrex Renegade, all right, because it didn't have any of the fancy stuff. You pick a point A, point B, of a predefined distance. So Urangan Boat Harbour over to Moon Point and back, all right? And for just calculation purposes, I'm gonna say it's 10Ks, all right? It's not 10Ks, but just using 10Ks as an example. I fill my tank up, 60 litres, full. I then go and do that journey. So I travel from Urangan Boat Harbour to Moon Point, Moon Point back to Urangan Harbour at my average cruising speed, okay? Don't go wide open throttle. Don't go trolling speed, just at your average traveling speed in your vessel, all right? So I've gone there, 10Ks, back, 10Ks. I know I've covered 20 kilometers, all right? We've traveled our 20 kilometers, take the boat out of the water and we go straight to the fuel bowser and we top up our tank. Because what we need to put back in there to make it full is how much fuel we have burnt. Rightio, so let's say we top the tank up and it takes 5 litres to top the tank up, all right? That means we have traveled 20 kilometres and we've burnt 5 litres of fuel. From there, you can work out the burn rate while traveling at your average speed. Now, 20 kilometres, 5 litres, all right, means that you're achieving 4 kilometres per litre, okay? 20 divided by 5 gives you the 4. All right, so 4 kilometers per liter, which works out as about 0.250, so 250 milliliters of fuel per kilometer. Do it a couple of times. So next time you go on a fishing trip, work out the distance you're gonna travel, travel at cruising speed and do it again and do it again. Do it 3 or 4 times so that you have a nice average to work off. You might find it goes from 4 to 3.8 to 4.2 or something like that, and you end up safely saying, I can do 4 kilometers per litre. That way then, you can work out, I'm going to Wathumba, it is a 40K trip to Wathumba, 40Ks back, so I'm gonna need at least 10 litres to get there, 10 litres to get back, and I need to have a third spare, so I'll carry an extra 10 litres as well, so I need at least 30 litres. So next time you're trying to work out how much fuel you need to get from point A to point B, you need to know the capacity of your tank. You need to know the burn rate of your motor at an average speed, an average cruising speed. And remember the rule of thirds. Third there, third back, third spare. Simple, all right? Hope it's as clear as mud. Send me a message if I've confused you and we'll sort it out.
How clear is this water?
Clear enough to swim. Look, there's
a plane. Hi, little plane. Did you wave to it?
I waved. tickles so much that you fall off.
All right. Can they come alongside without falling in? There's a bit of swell moving around. They're arguing the best way to come in alongside. We're about to have a collision at sea. Tricky docking procedures. Elliot, out of the way. Elliot, come and stand out of the way. Let them do it. Wow. Check that out. Can I hear the ocean? So this is where we've been exploring, folks. This little creek down here. Jen and Liam went for a spin up there on the paddleboard. They didn't take a camera, but I'll try and show you on the drone. What do you reckon, folks? What was it like?
The water was orange.
Orange?
Orangey, yeah. Black. Lots of tannins from all, yeah, the trees and things like that. It was a bit funny because there was a tree that had fallen down over the top of the creek. We were debating how to get around it. So Liam went over and I lay under as we went on the board. So
and I got stuck
on the way back. Yes, he's probably got splinters on his inner thighs or something.
When it was so it was a bit of fun?
It was a bit of fun. We chickened out. As we got up, because Liam thought there might be crocodiles. So
crocodiles?
I don't know.
No. Good. All right.
It's good fun.
Let's go up to Wathumba and have some lunch, eh?
Yep.
Yep.
We're coming into the mouth of Wathumba. Sorry about the wind. That's why we're coming in here to have lunch, to get out of the wind. It always pays to take it slow coming into this place because the mouth, the entrance, what's that there, dear? Moves around quite a lot. Sandbanks are constantly moving. So you can see the sandbank out here builds up quite a lot. Another sandbank over here. It's a bit of a channel and then it wraps right around to the edge of the beach and then follows right around on the beach. So you definitely don't want to come in here too hard. One of those and be stuck here for a while.
That was the little plane that we waved to when we were paddleboarding. Fish, there's fish everywhere. I don't think anyone can see them.
I just got a plug up.
That's cool. Pretty cool, isn't that? A seaplane? Where are you going to land? Pretty cool.
Good.
Very cool. Bit of cloud cover is ruining the colours. Usually the colours of the water are spectacular. There's a little seaplane. We're tucked up around the corner. The tide is pushing in. Absolutely gorgeous. You having a bit of a dig next to the anchor. Diggy dig, nice and soft.
I'm putting this next to the anchor to get
cooking lunch, dear.
Mm-hmm. What's taking a little while.
So, got the gas cook turned up. What are we having?
Lamb.
Oh, lamb cutlets.
My secret.
He's about to take off, isn't he, Lamb?
Yeah.
We'll get to see the plane take off. That'll be exciting.
Very exciting.
I can think of worse places to be stuck, to be honest. Not that we're stuck.
I was just about to say, we're not stuck. We're flying.
I can think of worse places to be. Let's put it that way. A lot worse places to be. Right, the plane's moving. Everybody's excited. Well, he reckons once he starts accelerating and gets up on the plane, he doesn't need much at all. So what's it marinated in, dear?
Secret.
We can't tell anybody.
I can. No. I've got stuff stuck in my teeth.
Probably. Let's film it. You like the marinade?
Some of the secret marinade.
What is the marinade?
Lemon.
Lemon juice.
Some salt.
Salt.
Some garlic. some dried mint and some dried oregano.
Ooh.
Oh, and some dried paprika.
Paprika, right.
Yum.
Mmm. Yum, yum. Really lunchtime. At Wathumba. Feeding the fish. I'll just zoom in so you can see the track that we used to come into Wathumba. Okay, so that's the general shape of it to get in here, to avoid all the sandbanks. Alright, but it does move around, so don't take that as gospel because it changes all the time, so take it easy coming in here. We're about to start heading back down to the bay. We might have a fish on the way back. Because it's starting to get chilly. What is it? Almost 2:30. By about 3:30 it'll be quite chilly. So we'll start heading back, I think. And the other features on here, which I'll show you, is you can, so you got your GPS up, you can change your layers and turn your GPS satellite imagery on. Yeah. Satellite imagery is not much good out there, but inside, when you're coming into creeks and things, it's quite handy, especially for down in the Great Sandy Strait. So just another little feature, which is very cool. Okay, time to pack up.
So I'll just tell you how much, like our fuel stats for us getting here, just so you've got a rough average. If you do have a motor about this size, 27.7 nautical miles is what we've covered. Alright, because we stopped at a few places, had a bit of a play around, and we've used 25 litres of fuel. So 25 litres to get here, should be about 25 to get back, and you'd want to have that 25 spare. Now I am going to push a little wider on the way back to go see if there's some fish around. So I'll probably end up maybe using 25, maybe using 30, so.
Join us next week as we head out fishing in some very ordinary conditions and give you a full review of our Fusion 19 boat. Nothing pretty about this review, folks. Rough conditions, water on the deck, and good honest feedback.